which takes us through a journey from the composer's point of view of environmental awareness, environmental understanding and compassion. And you know, this composer puts her money where her mouth is. She very much raises funds and awareness for the various environmental projects she's involved with. And this is a work from her heart about that. And so it's kind of a fun exploration of her vision of these different types of wilderness scenes and different types of wilderness, you know, senses, so to speak. And it really explores, for the musicians, this explores a lot of different times, different meters, different experiences, all kind of very quickly. And it's not your typical formulaic kind of work where you know you have your beginning, which we normally call like an A section, then we have a B section, then it kind of comes back to an A section to let you know, oh, this song is wrapping up. This is much more of an exploration of different scenes very quickly. And then at the end, she just sort of puts them all together very cleverly, so you kind of get callbacks very quickly, and then we're out of the wilderness. So I hope you enjoy Wilderness. conductor, who has worked very hard this semester and is accomplished a great deal and has grown a lot. I know I'm very proud of her. I believe Dr. Franklin's very proud of her. And she's just done a wonderful job. This next tune by Frank Dekelly, by the way, Frank Dekelly is a, Dr. Franklin and I were just kind of talking about this. He's one of these folks in our profession that has sort of carved out his own language. He just really understood the assignment, so to speak. He's been a wonderful voice for wind band. He's written a cornucopia of literature from a young band to the very advanced kind of ensembles in our profession. And all of them are just so well crafted. You know, we can all debate whether you like this tune or don't like that tune, and that's fine. But it just in terms of its craft, he has just really put together a career where he can really take a melody and just bring out its essence and just work with it. And that's what you're about to hear. Four movements, and this work, and please read about it in the program. Dr. Franklin worked really hard on that program, so please, please. But in all seriousness, this is just a wonderful tune, and this ensemble has tackled it with such grace and professionalism. And I'll stop talking so that you can please welcome to the stage, Carla Henson. work. That's a lot. It goes by fast when you're standing there, I know. But, that was a lot of work. That was the largest work that we did this cycle. So she really put in a lot of work, and as you heard, it paid off. And how about a round of applause for this ensemble? I've been telling them all semester how much they mean to me because it's my chance to, you know, make music and make art. And we've had a lot of fun this semester. Have we had a lot of fun this semester?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And you know, it means a lot to me. And I, you know, truly, I love you guys, and it means a lot. So I just want to say thank you to them, and thank you to you for coming. This last tune we're going to do by Bruce Yurko is kind of sentimental to me in a weird way. It was my first work that I conducted at a conference. I was an assistant director of bands in Charleston, South Carolina, at Charleston Southern, and we were invited to play at the South Carolina convention. And the director of bands, he invited me to do a work, and I don't know what attracted me to this work so much, but it really speaks to me because I guess I'm just like all that, just abstract and kind of allowing your imagination to run wild kind of music. And this tune, Night Dances, you know, it's supposed to be a spiritual kind of thing and evoke just different characters and different ideas. And it, well, I think you'll understand when you hear it. It just has a lot of different elements to it that showcases our percussion and just a lot of harmony. It's not melodically driven, which drives my wife crazy. She loves melody, and I love kind of harmonic driven stuff, but you know, apples and oranges, that's why we're together, I guess. Anyway, it's a shout out to my wife, I love you very much. So I'm going to finish up this concert, and again, thank you for being here. The next ensemble is gonna knock your socks off, so please hang around for that one, it's gonna be awesome. All right, let's get to it. This is Night Dances.
All these moving pieces. Thank you.
take an IDL in Wisconsin.
You don't know me very well, do you?
I told you to tear my pants, but nobody believes me.
Hey, great job, you guys. I hope you have a great semester. Finish up strong. I'm not going to see you on Thursday, but please be here Thursday. We've got to do some. If I don't see you again, I just know that you made my semester so great.
Come by and see me. And finish strong, guys.
There are three things I love the most about my job. Number one, getting to make music every single day of my life. Something I always try to not take for granted. Second thing is getting to make music with these wonderful students behind me, and getting to see them every single day, see them grow, and see them thrive, and see them struggle, and get back up, and continue to become the best versions of themselves. And then thirdly, is being able to work with just amazing colleagues, including this wonderful musician who's gonna be solo with us tonight, part of the canon of clarinet literature, fabulous musician. If you're around this area, you'll see her performing many, many times because she's one of the preeminent clarinetists of our region and a wonderful person to boot. Please welcome to the stage, Ms. Kristen Sheridan Sanders, please.
Thank you. Thank you.
long story medium. A few weeks ago, I was having a conversation with some of our graduate assistants who were in the band, playing the ensemble behind us. We were talking about our program for tonight, and this next piece, which is the sort of the centerpiece of our portion of tonight's program, it's called Crump. And if you haven't taken the time to look at through the extended digital version of the program notes, I encourage you to do that. There's a lot of great information about this particular piece with an interesting name, Crump. And the piece is really inspired by a trend, a dancing trend, that sprouted in the 1990s and still continues today in South Central LA. And it has a lot of energy to it, a lot of energy that you may not be expecting from a piece called Crump. Anyway, I was talking to my students and conversing about this, and the idea came to my mind. How cool would it be if we could have a concert where we actually included Crump dancing and dancers in that? I kind of tucked it away because I had a lot of things going on, but little did I know that my grad student Noelle, back here in the trumpet section, say hi over here. Noelle, being the dutiful student she is, a representative of our fine students here at Georgia Southern University, started doing some sleuthing, and she is in contact with a group called Crump Atlanta. And so before we play our version of Crump, I thought the best thing for me to do would be to step aside, invite our friends from Crump Atlanta here to talk a little about what Crump is and to give a little demonstration of their performance here too. So without further ado, we please welcome our friends from Crump Atlanta to the stage here.
Good evening, everyone. How y'all doing? Okay. I'm a very kind of interactive person. We're gonna be giving you a lot of energy tonight, so don't be afraid to, you know, just interact with us, clap, holler, stand up, you know, all that kind of stuff. Okay. For one, I want to thank Dr. Franklin and the program here for allowing us to come and share what we do, and to also integrate our different arts, forms of art. Definitely a really big creative. I used to play in the band myself in the Wind Ensemble at Fayette County High School, if anybody knows where that is. But really have enjoyed this journey that dancing has taken me with music. And one of the things that's near and dear to all of us is how music makes us feel and how it makes us move and how it makes us think. One of the things that I really wanted to bring to you guys today with Crump Atlanta is just showing you guys, you know, how we actually paint movement in empty space. As musicians, a lot of us, you know, who have created music, we're used to painting empty space with sound, and bringing those different sounds together in order to communicate a message, in order to communicate a feeling.
And it's the same thing. It's the same thing with movement. So what we're hoping to do today and what we're looking forward to do is just to share Crump with you guys. Yes, originated out of South Compton, LA, but now it's a worldwide movement. You can find people pretty much on every continent except for Antarctica. I don't know if anybody's doing it on Antarctica.
But
all the other continents, there's people who's doing this dance, enjoying it, and just coming together. So I think at the end of the day, what I want to communicate is music brings us together. Music is what brought you guys here today. Music is what keeps us alive. It's what puts that spark in us. It's one of the most beautiful things that we have as human beings. And it's also what I believe one of the greatest mysteries, because who knows how many different sounds we can come up with in order to express the cacophony of all of the things that happen in our lives. It just comes together. All the big moments, the small moments, little moments, and that's what I love about music. That's what I love about what you guys are doing, and I hope you guys enjoy what we have to bring. Oh yeah. Oh, as for me, I forgot to introduce ourselves. Really quick introduction. My name is Slash. I help lead a lot of what we do with Crump Atlanta. You can find us on Instagram or Facebook at Crump. That's K-R-U-M-P underscore Atlanta. I have a man KO, Kix, and Linky. We all have our different dance backgrounds in our names that kind of represent that as well as what we do. So without further ado, I think we're gonna go ahead and set up. You guys get positioned. Y'all good?
Thank you.
being here this evening, especially if you're here for recital attendance. Hopefully, if it's your first band concert, you thought that, wow, I didn't think it could be that much fun. I would love for you to come back and be a part of this again. And in fact, we'd love for you to be part of this as performers as well. So if you are a high school student here, shameless plug, we would love to tell you more about our program here. So fill out the little QR code thing on the inside cover of the program. If you are a musician, band musician of any age in here, retired, working, student, and have had at least a few years of high school experience, there's an opportunity for you to play in our bands here. We have a band called University Band that meets on Monday nights from 7 to 9 p.m. during the spring semester. There's information that you can find out about that in the program as well, too. We'd love to see many community members joining our bands, being part of this as well, too. So thank you again for coming tonight. Thank you again to Crump Atlanta for being here and sharing your up-and-coming composer, do a lot of